Hi folks, this is Melvin from optoproductions.com, continuing with our Mutable Instruments tour. This time we take a look at the mutable instruments, tides. Tides, aka the tidal modulator in VCV Rec, is a looping envelope generator. This means that we have an attack and decay curve, which can be played once to create an envelope, or repeated to create an LFO. We can change between the attack and decay looping mode with this button over here. So the first mode, indicated by the green LED, is an attack and decay curve. The second is a continuous curve, or an LFO. And the third is an attack and release mode. So in this mode, we can use a gate input to hold down notes, acting like a sustain phase. The sustain level in this case is all the way up, which is a maximum of 8 volts in this case. With regular looping envelopes, you have a separate attack and decay phase, by which you can control the speed. With tides, the attack and decay phase are combined, and the total rate is set by the frequency knob. We can change the ratio between the attack and decay curves by using the slope knob. Shortening the attack when we turn the knob to the left, as you can see on the scope. And if we turn it to the right, we will shorten the release in this case, or the decay in the first mode. Tides has 4 outputs, and the first being the main output. I'll talk about the other 3 in a moment. When we first load up Tides, it starts up in the default mode. Tides actually has 4 different modes, which we can change with the top right button. When the LED is off, that's the default mode. And this mode is called the level mode. So in this mode, the shift or level knob over here controls the output volume of the first output. So if you're not getting any signal, turn up this button. Okay, I'm quickly gonna grab an LFO so I don't have to push manually each time. And I'm gonna connect a square wave output to the trigger input. Oh, and by the way, if you turn the level knob to the left, the output is inverted. So right now, we've got a triangle wave. We can change the shape by turning the upper right control. So let me slow down the frequency a little bit and turn on trigger. All kinds of shapes which we can further modify with the slope control. We can also control the shape with the smoothness knob. When you turn this knob to the left, it will add a low pass filter to the envelope, therefore softening out the curve. And if you turn it to the right, it will do the opposite, roughening up the sound with a wave folder. And as you can see, it really makes the envelope rough. And this can be useful to emulate more unstable analog envelopes. In the upper left corner, we have one more button. And this changes the overall audio rate, or the range in which the frequency knob works. So the first mode, in green, creates ultra slow curves. You can really create minute-long envelopes in this mode. The yellow mode is more for medium envelopes. And the third mode works at audio rate. Now let's take a look at the different outputs. In our current mode, the second output will output just the raw triangle wave. So if we change the shape, the first output will change, but the second doesn't. and also the level of the first output will change with the level knob, but not the second output. The third output will create a gate signal starting from the end of the attack phase, up until the release phase. And the fourth output will output a trigger at the end of the release phase. Right, moving on to the next mode. And in this mode we can smoothly blend between the different outputs. And this is useful if you want to send the envelope to four different VCAs, for example. Alright, so I've set up a quad VCA with each output of tides going into it and all the outputs of a VCO used as inputs. So in this mode, if I turn up the level knob, we first get output 1, then output 1 and 2, 2 and 3, and 3 and 4. So we can mix between the four different envelope outputs. The third mode, indicated by the yellow LED, will shift the time of every output. In attack and decay or attack and release mode, this will shift the slope of each output. And in looping mode, this will shift the phase. So if we connect all outputs to a scope and we give it a trigger. So right now, all outputs are in phase. And if I turn the knob to the right, each output will have a different slope. Might be easier to see in cycling mode. Right, you get the point. The last red mode changes the frequency of each output. Turning the shift knob clockwise will increase the speed of outputs 2, 3 and 4, and turning it anti-clockwise will decrease the speed. And this can be very cool at audio rate. So right now I'm in the fourth mode and I'm using cyclic mode, and the frequency range is set to audio rate, so we can use it as an oscillator. And as soon as we turn the level knob, actually get chords out of it. If you look at the LEDs in attack and decay mode, you can clearly see the frequency changing, speeding up or slowing down. Okay, let's take a look at the clock input. When you patch an LFO or oscillator signal into the clock input, tides will match its frequency to this incoming signal. Kinda like a word clock input on an audio interface. So in this patch right here, I've got a sequencer triggering a pico drums on each step. And the clock of this sequencer is going to be the clock input of tides. With the frequency knob set to 12 o'clock, it should match up nicely. So if I press run, so this is the sample coming from the pico drums. And it's mixed in with a VCO. I can divide the clock or multiply the clock in rhythmic intervals. And all the time, when you return to 12 o'clock, the phase stays locked in place. Now if I connect a manual gate to the trigger input, and now if I press the push button, I can reset the envelope whenever I want. So I can create phase shifted rhythms. And all the time, the tempo stays sync with the original sequencer. If I disconnect the trigger input, it will sync back up. So that's pretty cool. All right, let's take a look at another example. Okay, so right here I have a similar patch as before, with a quad VCA, but this time I'm using four separate VCOs, so I can tune them differently. With the frequency mode activated, we can create interesting polyrhythms. So if I turn the shift knob, and especially if you use percentages of fractions, like 75, you can get interesting rhythms out of it. Or let's say 66. A second example patch is by sending an oscillator to the clock input, and this creates an harmonic oscillator. I've got a sequencer sending pitch information through a quantizer into a VCO, and the output of this VCO is going into the clock input of tides. With the frequency knob centralized, the frequency is the same as our oscillator. But as soon as I change the frequency knob to the right, we can create harmonics. And these are quantized to musical values. By the way, we are getting these clicks, and if you want to get rid of those, we need to use audio rate. And if you turn it to the left, we can create subharmonics. We can also change the sound of our harmonic oscillator by changing the shape. Or the smoothness. Slope. And so on. And now I wonder what happens if you use an audio input. Right, so I've got a guitar loop as a clock input. Now if I add the output of tides, well, it actually works. Right, that's it again for this module. I hope you learned something today, and if not, please let me know in the comments. And I'll see you next time in another VCV Rec tutorial.